A man, an animal, who has done it all in WWE.
The following contest is a triple threat match. Making his way to the ring from Washington, D.C., weighing in at 290 pounds, the animal, Batista!
We can list this man's accolades all day long. A former WWE champion, a Royal Rumble winner, a man who has main evented WrestleMania. And now Batista simply demands that the WWE Universe give him what he wants. Indeed, the largest superstar in the history of sports entertainment.
And his opponents, first from Grenoble, France.
That's the good stuff, yeah!
The agile and unpredictable Scripps is in the building.
Here we go with triple threat rules in effect for this one, folks. All set for competition in this one, and kicking it off, we see Batista, Andre the Giant, and Scripps.
Never a moment of respite in these triple threat bouts. Each superstar will have to be very deliberate with all of their actions. You don't want to have any wasted motion, any wasted energy.
Oh. Ooh-hoo-hoo.
Great strength being shown here.
Oh, man, that's the esophagus.
Cut off. Oh, and he breaks up the pin. Perhaps thinking about what to do next here. Oh, right to the throat. Andre gets reversed.
Hooked up.
Shin breaker. Spinning side slam. And that has Scripps searching for answers.
Yeah, it looks like Batista is savoring the hunt of his opponent.
No clue what he hopes to find down there.
He has a kendo stick in hand, and this place just turned into South Swanson Street.
What a suplex.
Given the no disqualification modifier on this match, Corey, what kind of tactics should you expect to see here?
Ruthless tactics, Cole. Now is the time for these superstars to unleash their pent-up aggression and be as violent as they want. There's nothing the ref can do about it, so they should go all out.
Okay, he's re-entering the ring. Caught in a bad position here.
Someone call a dentist.
Pulled back into the hip toss. I honestly can't believe we just saw a human being tossed like that.
Boom, running STO plants.
Nicely done.
Just ruthless.
Batista is just playing with his food right now.
Clearly hoping something nefarious is beneath the ring.
Shades of the old EC Dub as a kendo stick.
A bear hug, squeezing the breath.
He breaks up the hold.
Nice takedown.
And he wants nothing to do with any of that. Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want. He's reaching under the ring for anything useful.
Sledgehammer. Better call the paramedics right now.
Ooh, that hurt right to the kidney.
Golly.
That caught Andre square. He might have only poked the the bear, though.
Batista wanted to go hunting. He is now.
Is it enough? The cover! Two!
Andre still able to kick out there. Incredible!
What a match.
Steer clear of that.
Batista with a patent. And this match will head back to the ring.
Andre is in big, big trouble.
For the victory here.
And there's the breakup just in the nick of time.
Uh-oh. This isn't going to be pretty.
Suplex. Does he get him here?
He stops the count.
Oh, flapjack.
Gosh, landing face first.
Down with force. And what need is there to go looking under the apron like this?
Funky butt loving. He's got a baseball bat. Oh, jeez. Laying the lumber. What a triple threat.
Here is your winner.
He has returned from the fifth dimension.
Making his way to the ring from the fifth dimension, weighing in at 220 pounds, Stardust!
According to Stardust, the man we knew as Cody Rhodes is gone forever.
Yeah, once upon a time, Stardust overtook the vessel known as Cody Rhodes, but now he's become powerful enough to...
It's fight night!
Behold the power of the Celtic Warrior.
And his opponents, first from Dublin, Ireland.
Here comes the Scottish Supernova.
An accomplished superstar who has made his name in NXT and WWE.
Hope these superstars have their heads on a swivel for this triple threat match.
You ain't kidding, because there are three competitors and it's also no disqualification, which means things have the potential to get very chaotic here.
If a shortcut presents itself, you better take it.
That showed a complete lack of respect for your competition and for our sport.
Boom, running FTO plants him.
Nicely done. Sent into the corner.
Oh, down by the DDT.
Uh-oh.
Face first in the turnbuckle.
Planning on what to do next.
Ooh, pinpointing the trachea.
Into the ring now.
Uh-oh.
Able to avoid there.
Oh, man, inverted backbreaker.
Out. A flat-out power into the scoop slam. Oh, look at the double team here.
Uh-oh.
Oh, face first.
Dar losing some focus on the task at hand.
Yeah, there is no doubt that Sheamus's heart is pumping vinegar now. Punishing.
Uh-oh.
Oh, what a hip toss.
Whoa, that was nice. Settling around the kendo stick. No good can come from this. Oh, he knew exactly what he was looking for when he started digging under the apron. No one just finds a sledgehammer.
Corey, in your mind, what's the best strategy to take in a triple threat match?
Unfortunately, there's no one right answer. These matches are too unpredictable to plan for, but a good rule of thumb is to be aggressive and control the action in the ring.
Setting up. Oh, vicious Russian leg sweep.
Right into the barricade. Brought back into the ring from the floor now.
Going right after the arm of their opponent, applying the arm bar. Nice takedown.
Punished. And here's a cover. Wow, the ref got hit hard there. He kicks out instantly.
A little over eager with that cover.
He's been placed in the corner now. Boom! What a right!
Gosh.
No! What a slam!
Alabama style.
The amount of force behind that is enough to knock a normal person out.
Rolling through. He'll head to the ring.
First a knife-edge chop, and now continuing the attack on the knee.
Straight to the knee.
An effective attack to the leg can hurt everything from balance to mobility. It can drastically limit you inside the ring.
Heads out, and he has all the time he wants.
Determination in his eyes, and now a kendo stick in his hands. Oh, man, a kendo shot to the head. That can't feel good.
Just one right after the other can't be stopped. Dark matter. Looks like some words have been exchanged.
And body language is telling me they might not have been the kindest.
At this point in the match, that could have gone either way.
A show of disrespect from Dark.
Stardust closing out. Things are starting to break down. Oh, no. Two friends collide.
Not the desired target.
As was this.
Oh, no.
It keeps getting worse. Quick, say you're sorry.
And this one might be headed ringside.
Oh, a sledgehammer.
Canadian backbreaker submission. Agonizing position, looking to pry the grip apart. And they do.
Doing whatever it takes.
What's he hoping to find down there?
Oh, man. Ladies and gentlemen, batter up.
He's doing a whole lot of gesturing, and it could cost him. Great counter.
Oh, my God.
Look at this.
Off from the rope. Here he goes for the win.
Can he close it out?
And there's the breakup, just in the nick of time.
That is just pure instinct at this point.
Looking for something, anything under the ring.
From the top rope,
and he's able to reverse. Whatever's playing here can't be good.
Right across the larynx. He's getting pushed out into the defensive. This should come as no surprise. In a havoc-filled triple threat, you're gonna take some big hits.
How are they gonna hear after this match?
A show of disrespect from Dar.
He's certainly lining him up, but he's wasting too much time. Climbs back inside.
Nicely done.
And he has free reign to the outside with no countouts to worry about. He's looking for an implement of destruction under the ring.
A steel chair? Something we all know can be a devastating weapon.
These are dangerous attacks on their own, but now the damage is exponentially multiplied.
I don't care who you are. You can't take consecutive attacks like that without it affecting you.
And things are just going from bad to worse.
This is just getting uncomfortable at this point.
And it is getting downright nastier and nastier with each of these attacks.
So much punishment has been absorbed by these men already.
And yet, they are still going, still ready for more.
Veteran instincts from Sheamus. Punishing their opponent.
Loving blow to the chest. He's heading back to the ring.
Ooh, a vicious shot right to the dome.
Boom!
Uh-oh. What a takedown. Fujiwara armbar. Oh, Fujiwara armbar applied.
Shit.
Up the pinfall.
Oh! Sheamus with a broom kick!
Stardust looks absolutely out of it.
Well, obviously, there are a lot of tensions between these two superstars as a result of what just went down in the ring.
Those tensions just got stronger.
And I don't think these two are gonna be
Here comes Indy Hartwell,
one of the toughest underdogs in the women's division.
Is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from Melbourne, Australia, Indy Hartwell.
Been successful her entire career from Australia to NXT, now ready to conquer WWE.
Yeah, what gives Indy Hartwell that advantage is her incredible strength. She almost always has the size advantage inside the ring.
Has already seen so much success in NXT and WWE.
Yeah, but Cole, Indy Hartwell is only getting better. It's time to square up.
Sonya Deville is all business, all attitude.
And from Chemung, New Jersey, Sonya Deville!
From the MMA world to Tough Enough to NXT to upper management, you can never count Sonya out.
Well, that MMA background you mentioned is what makes Sonya so dangerous, along with her.
Here we go, the powerhouse, Indy Hartwell, ready for action. Impressive athleticism, strong resilience.
Armoring her into the Kimura.
Oh my goodness, this man.
Her arm has got to be radiating in pain right now, but somehow, some way, she gets out.
Placing them right where they want them, into the corner. Chop echoing through the arena.
Yikes, that'll either wake you up or knock you out.
And it's reverse pain for that mistake.
Oh,
way to the outside.
Out of the ring, she has to mind the 10 count.
Carefully measured knee drop.
Hammerlock.
Reverse DDT.
Indy Hartwell is still relatively green when it comes to action in the WWE ring. How is she going to stack up against this opponent, Corey?
Experience is a factor, Cole, but raw talent always prevails. Indy Hartwell's innate ability has proven her to be a top superstar no matter where she steps through the ropes.
Thrown back in under the ropes.
Indy's got the juices flowing now, gentlemen. Snapping her back to reality. This isn't a pose off.
Drawing dangerously close to a count out here. Wow, the last second beat the count out.
Air whip! It couldn't have felt good being chucked around like that.
A quick finish. Can she do it? And bypasses the pinfall.
Optimistic thinking on that pin attempt.
She scores big with the counter. Oh, kick connects.
Sonya Deville connecting with a solid shot.
And Indy is looking a little more battered after sustaining that attack, guys.
Just ruthless. That was showing great awareness of positioning.
Nice transition, looking for the triangle armbar. Uh-oh, triangle armbar submission. Oh, no.
She's in trouble. Better find a way out, fighting desperately, and she's free.
Textbook fireman's carry takeover.
Don't do it!
Suicide dive!
Just a devil-may-care attitude on full display.
Going for broke, and it pays off.
Oh, man, right to the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow.
Elbow drop.
Piercing. Oof.
Kick to the gut. Ooh, brutal forearm.
And Indy has taken control.
The innate abilities of Hartwell on display. Indy wrestling with the early advantage.
A third.
Return fire from Deville.
And Sonya is finally able to mount some resistance with that.
She's tipping the scales here a bit.
You know, I've noticed some friction lately between these superstars.
Well, you can't be friends with everybody.
I've noticed the same. There's definitely something of a rivalry here.
A tremendous win for this superstar tonight. Certainly earned it. It wasn't easy.
Well, I think the loser realizes he wants to show respect.
Wow. And complete disrespect by the winner.
This is a deeply personal issue, and it doesn't appear to be completely resolved just yet.
Jimmy Uso is on his own, and he is the one.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from San Francisco, California, weighing in at 251 pounds, Jimmy Uso!
This is the individual who holds the bloodline down no matter what. Jimmy is the constant next to the Tribal Chief and always will be.
Since reaffirming his loyalty to the family, some have said that Jimmy's overcompensating to make up for his past sins. Jimmy knows every match is basically a must-win.
You might have noticed that Jimmy's moving a little quicker now that he's on his own. He doesn't have Jay weighing him down. Thank you.
I have got chills, gentlemen. The one and only, the Dragon.
And his opponent from Honolulu, Hawaii, weighing in at 235 pounds, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat!
Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, tremendously respected by the WWE Universe. What an ovation here.
A list of accolades a mile long, a proud, talented competitor. A true wrestler's wrestler.
And a true inspiration to anyone who has stepped inside the ring. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
One of the greatest superstars of all time, Ricky Steamboat, is ready for action.
One of the greatest and also one of the most decorated. It's hard to find a championship that doesn't have Steamboat's fingerprints on it. Making gold, making history, that's what the Dragon is all about.
We could very well see Ricky put on another historic performance here in this match.
But then we have Jimmy Uso, who is as tough and talented as ever. Jimmy has an unrelenting nature inside the ring, a willingness to do whatever needs doing to secure the win. That kind of single-minded aggressiveness makes him one dangerous opponent.
Yeah, there's an edge to Jimmy, a brutality that just can't be overlooked. You mess with him or his family, and he'll make sure there is hell to pay.
Lands an elbow!
He's returning fire. Ricky Steamboat connected with a good shot there. Jimmy Uso is obviously known for his explosiveness in the ring, but also his viciousness. How exactly does one prepare for that kind of combination? He could pin his opponent right here. Power right out in one.
He clearly has no intention of staying down. Not allowing that to go on any longer.
Nice striking combination.
Right, swinging neck breaker connects.
Oh, geez, falling hard to the outside. There's absolutely no regard for your opponent's safety when you toss them to the outside like that.
Rapid fire Samoan drop.
And Steamboat did not see that coming.
Yeah, that ruthless side of Jimmy just absolutely took over there.
Oof, well measured.
And Steamboat had it scouted.
Uh-oh.
And he had Steamboat's number there.
Ooh-wee.
The ref's count ain't stopping.
The clock is ticking here. He beats the count, and this one continues.
Taking head over heels.
Oh, and that buys some time.
Oh. Oh. Boot to the gut will stop anyone in their tracks.
Here's the Dragon, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Sleeper, and breaks out of the sleeper.
Oh, what a super kick, a double super kick.
For the win.
I think the fuse has been lit here, guys.
Yeah, Sack, and now we'll see if this is dynamite or a dud.
This is what you call high risk, high reward.
Top rope, Uso splash!
Steamboat couldn't avoid the big shot.
Three, no, two count!
Within inches of victory, only to have it snatched away.
This match just keeps getting more and more exciting.
And it's gonna take composure now. Could just need one more big move.
Oh, wicked kick to the lower back.
Drops the hammer.
Right on the lower back.
Great counter. Boom, what impact.
Flamed across the way.
He's absorbing some tough hits now.
At this stage of the match, they are clearly starting to feel the effects of this back and forth. Stops the attack with a hit to the gut. He eludes the contact.
Trapping both of their opponent's arms and hoisted up into a double chicken wing submission hold.
He's in complete control. Opponent has nowhere to go. Could be.
And he releases the hold.
I don't think he had it fully locked in.
Stump puller legs.
This could be it.
Cover for the win.
Celebration. And I believe the loser's hurt. He's calling the official over. May have a leg injury, guys.
We hate to see anybody injured after a hard-fought contest like we just witnessed. And even the victor showing a little respect. And ate a knuckle sandwich for his trouble.
That was ridiculous. This superstar should be ashamed of himself.
Now the matchup underway. Down.
And these two don't care at all.
What about the official? Someone check on him, please.
Someone's gonna get seriously hurt if this continues like this.
These two are going to tear each other apart.
And I love it.
Is that an official start?
The referee was able to start the match, so we are proceeding with this match.
Yeah, guys, there is no way that doesn't play a part in this one.
Saxton, in this business, you gotta keep your head on a swivel, no matter who you are. That was just a quick reminder. Just mocking their opponent right now. Total disrespect.
And I don't know if there's any ounce of professionalism in an attack like that.
Grabbing a hold of the arm.
And that was a well-executed attack.
Focusing on a body part, picking it apart. The arm's as good of a place to focus as any.
Big time clothesline.
Good grief.
Scott Hall clearly feels like he has a W within his grasp.
Gotta find a way to get out of this.
Oh, sent flying. No other way to say it, guys. That looked like it hurt a lot.
All the weight down.
He's absorbed some damage already.
Yeah, a very motivated Gunther in front of us. And what a burning lariat. Hip drop.
And what do you think Gunther's strongest asset is in this match, Corey?
You know why they call Gunther the Ring General, Cole? Because he commands the match. Lean on that power and that ruthlessness to keep the match in control and beat the fight out of his opponent.
Oh, my. How about decapitate it?
Maybe that will shut him up. And he said, "You're not getting me with that this time."
Held in a perilous position.
Ooh, right to the throat.
Oh, look at that torture their opponent. Uh-oh, this isn't going to be good. Oh, man. Got him set up in the corner of the ring. Scoop slam.
Hall is just adding insult to injury here.
Insulting.
Gunther's face is starting to look mangled after that.
Keep it up.
Discus punch.
And so much for ending a match before it starts. Gunther got the fight taken to him there.
Yeah, as Hall is up to his bad guy moniker with that offense. Come on! Just how desperate do you have to be? Why not a fair fight, huh?
Oh my God, what impact.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless.
Enough already.
Oh, my God, what impact.
Going right for the torso. to the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow.
Good defense.
The ring general
driven down with the powerbomb. This is troublesome for Scott.
There was absolutely no way the bad guy was going to stay down like that. Far too much fight in a guy like Scott Hall.
And Gunther definitely thought that would put him down. I can't imagine he's going to take it easy on him after such a defiant kick out. You hear the talk in the locker room, the anything you can do, I can do better mentality that's been building between these competitors.
I've noticed just how much they've been trying to one-up each other as of late, and I'm liking what I'm seeing.
Dropped him with a big shoulder tackle. Setting up for something here.
Oh, driven face first into the apron.
Delivering nasty stumps.
Battling ringside, and our announce table's getting shaky.
That's because Byron is quivering in fear next to me.
I get nervous when the fight comes out here, guys.
Say hello to the bad guy and goodbye to his opponent.
Should do it right there.
Cover.
And he's still in the game.
Gunther is down, but not out. Such a competitive drive, refusing to let this be over.
But Hall is not one to let that through.
Oh, look at the start of this. Could be going into the playbook for submission.
He turns it around on Hall.
Taking a moment to get pumped off of this crowd's incredible energy.
Snap power slam.
He's running on right now.
Not what you want to see by any means.
Yeah, but guys, Hall still has some machismo left in him.
Gunther wants to finish this, delivering a powerbomb. It's all Gunther's.
That's it. The blood and sweat put into this match, well worth it.
Dirty Dom is on the loose.
On the loose? I'm pretty sure he's a free man.
Yeah, and the streets are saying it's going to be a good night for Poppy. The toughest young superstar in all of WWE and in Cell Block 6.
Well, Dom has had big shoes to fill, and he has certainly done all that he can, for better or worse, to make a name for himself in this industry.
Come on!
It's a big fight feel here tonight as the title is on the line.
And title matches like this have a way of getting your blood flowing unlike any other match.
And very quickly, I can tell you that these superstars are very excited to have the opportunity to compete here tonight on Independence Day.
And similarly, we're excited to be able to call the action for you, especially for this match. This is going to be great.
Introducing the challenger from San Diego, California, weighing in.
Intensity on the face of the champion, challenger in the corner, looking more determined than I've ever seen. There's just something in the air when the bell rings and you see the eyes of the dead man intense and focused on the match at hand.
Oh yeah, many men have come face to face with The Undertaker and they have all fallen victim to his menacing demeanor and preternatural in-ring skill. Not to mention his power and surprising agility for a man his size.
That's the thing about Taker. He can beat you in so many ways even before the match starts.
And he's squaring off against the pariah of the Mysterio family, Dominic.
Put some respect on Dom's name, Saxton, or he'll show you the true meaning of prison justice.
The champion hoping to take the arm out of commission.
Look at this. Snap suplex. Set up in the corner of the ring. Uses the edge of the knee. And that might shape Mysterio's focus.
Yeah, just like Taker to prove why he really is one of a kind.
Heads out of the ring, but needs to be mindful of the ref. Goes under the ropes to get back inside. The absolute intimidation of The Undertaker in effect here. Pressing their foot right into the gut. That's gotta hurt. The young Dominic Mysterio looking to fire up the audience here. You know, you really can't ignore just how much intimidation plays a part in The Undertaker's success. How important do you think it will be in this match tonight?
Like you said, Cole, it's definitely a key component, but he's got other tools. And if I know The Undertaker, he's gonna be staying on his opponent tonight, refusing to let him breathe.
Good God, that's devastating.
Setting him up for the flatliner.
Man, face first.
Taking the fight near our announce table.
I really hope we get these desks at a discount.
And back in the ring we go.
Does the official not see him removing the turnbuckle
pad? Here's the pin. Title on the line. Quick shoulder up.
Kicking out so early certainly sends a message.
Oh, what a big uppercut.
What the leg?
Look at this.
He just tossed the leg.
Just a perfect mix of pure power and bad intentions.
And that prevents Undertaker's attack.
Smarter, not harder. That's what I said.
Just look at Undertaker gain the momentum in this one.
And that's the clear result of Taker refusing to let his opponent have any breathing room.
And he sends him into the corner. High risk area up there. Oh, no, 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 no. Not from up there. Super choke slam.
You can almost see the soul leave the body. That's how much force Taker put into that.
The dead man lining up his next victim moments away.
Taker has him up. Here we go.
Tombstone pile driver.
Can it be? Will the rain continue?
Cover! Two count. Retains the title.
Here is your winner, and still the WWE Intercontinental Champion, The Undertaker!
Big win as he retains the championship.
He came out here and defended what was his. You have to give him credit.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
Guys, here comes the hot mess.
Emphasis on mess?
Bite your tongue, Saxton.
The High-Flying Hall of Famer.
Just as responsible for the women's revolution as anybody.
You know, so many of today's top women stars say they were inspired by Lita. The likes of Becky Lynch, Bayley, Liv Morgan.
Yeah, but Lita wants to be more than just an inspiration. Lita wants to remain a top WWE and prove she is still at the top of her game.
Introducing the challenger. From Victoria, British Columbia, Canada.
That is what it's all about. What every woman claws and scratches for. The Women's World Championship.
The Women's World Championship on the line here in this matchup.
Whoever wins this one, no doubt we're looking at the unequivocal top dog of the women's division.
Without a doubt, Corey, the top prize in the division up for grabs.
How about the strength of the champ? Just flinging off the challenger.
Right in the face.
My God.
Placing them into the corner. Oh, my God.
Face for the title.
She kicks out at one.
Impressive to not even allow a two count at this juncture.
Oh, an eye rake.
That's not right, but effective.
Harsh forearm draped across the middle rope.
And down. Oof.
She heads out of the ring, but she needs to pay attention to the ref's count.
Oh, man.
Battling at ringside can be very unforgiving. You have to be careful out there.
No protection out here. No safe confines to speak of.
Lita has proven over the years to be one of the toughest superstars, male or female, in this industry. How do you prepare for someone with that kind of reputation, Corey?
The idea of trying to outdo Lita's toughness is easier said than done. The key is to remind yourself not to let up on the offense. Because tough doesn't mean invincible, and everyone has their limits, even Lita.
Up goes Lita, thinking extreme.
Launching.
Has the challenger pinned. Is this it? Kick out at one for the challenger.
She just shocked everyone in the ring.
Got their opponent set up.
Drop kick to the back.
Ooh, dropped right on their face.
And Lita's keeping the match at her pace.
Chelsea needs to find a way to reverse her fortunes.
Lita setting it up.
With the reverse twist of fate. Absolutely on the mark with that one.
I've never seen Lita hit that as perfectly as she just did.
Drop kick hits the mark.
From the top.
And she doesn't connect.
Now laser focused on the temple and back of the neck.
The champ taking their share of hits now.
Chelsea's offensive wherewithal was on point.
Oh, an eye rake.
That's not.
Locking up the arms from behind.
And prettier.
The title's in jeopardy here.
I think the paradigm has shifted.
Two. Almost had her, but she gets the shoulder up. Elbow drop with authority. Attack.
Trying to wrestle free their opponent's arm, has the arm trapped.
Goodness gracious.
Lita's hopes are waning here.
Let's appreciate how she's sticking to
from the top.
Oh, elbow drop. Oh, piercing elbow.
The official's concerned with the wrong thing right now. They're completely missing the pin.
This is going to come down to who wants it more.
Setting them up. Canadian Destroyer.
That ego of Chelsea's has to be growing after that attack.
Locking up the arms from behind.
There's the eye prettier by Chelsea Green. We can have a new champion.
Cover.
Two. Chelsea Green is our new champion. What a moment.
Here is your
the now former champion, obviously not happy with this outcome.
I did not think a title change was in the cards here tonight.